Hi guys, today we are going to do the divisibility rule. First of all, we will do the divisibility by 2. What is the rule? The rule is any number which is having the last digit 0 or even number is always divisible by 2. So, whatever number is given to you, you have to just see the last digit. Take a look at the first example. Suppose you are given the number 14. The last digit of this number is 4, which is an even number. So, this number 14 will be divisible by 2. One another example. Suppose you are given the number 88. Here the last digit is 8, which is an even number. So, if the last digit is an even number or it is 0, then this number is divisible by 2. So here in this example, 88, the last digit is 8, which is an even number. So 88 is divisible by 2. Next, 140. 140 is having the last digit 0. So it is also divisible by 2. Number 573924. The last digit of this number is 4. Which is an even number. So this number is also divisible by 2. So this is the divisibility rule for 2, that if any number with last digit 0 or even number, then this number is always divisible by 2. Next is divisibility by 3. Now, how you can find out without doing the actual division that whether the number given number is divisible by 3 or not? You can follow this rule that if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then that number is also divisible by 3. For example, suppose you are given the number 243. What you have to do, add all the digits. 2 plus 4 plus 3. 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. So, this number 9. 9 is divisible by 3. So, the number 243 will also be divisible by 3. In the same way, suppose you are given 6, 5, 3, 7. Add all the digits. 6 plus 5 plus 3 plus 7. Which is equal to 6 plus 5, 11, 11 plus 3, 14, 14 plus 7 is 21. 21 is divisible by 3. So the given number 6537 will also be divisible by 3. So what you have to do, add all the digits and whatever will be their sum, if that sum is divisible by 3, then the given number will also be divisible by 3. Now, one another example. 14378. Add all the digits. 1 plus 4 plus 3 plus 7 plus 8. The total sum is 23. Now 23 is not divisible by 3. So the given number 14378 will not be divisible by 3. Next is divisibility by 4. How you can check whether the number is divisible by 4 or not without doing the actual calculation. So you can follow this rule. What is the rule? First, if the last two digits of the number are divisible by 4, you have to check only the last two digits. If the last two digits are divisible by 4, then the number will always be divisible by 4. And second thing, if the last two digits are 0 or more zeros are there in the end, but last two digits must be equal to 0, then that number is always divisible by 4. Okay, let's do some examples. Suppose you are given the number 32636. Here the last two digits, they are 36. 36 is divisible by 4. 4 times 9 is 36. So this complete number 32636 is also divisible by 4. Now, if you are given 5500, here the last two digits are 0. So this number 5500 is also divisible by 4. Suppose you are given 112000. Here, last two digits are 0. More zeros can be there, but last two digits must be 0. So this number is also divisible by 4. Now, 12434. Here, the last two digits are 34. But 34 is not divisible by 4. So this number 12434 is not divisible by 4. So next rule is divisibility by 5. Okay. Suppose you are given any number. If that number ends with 0 or 5. Then that number is always divisible by 5. For example, you are given 1245. Here the last digit is 5. The last digit must be 5 or 0. In 1245, the last digit is 5. So that number is divisible by 5. Next is 1740. Here the last digit is 0. So last digit can be 0 or 5. Then the number will be divisible by 5. Here the last digit is 0. So this number will also be divisible by 5. Now suppose you are given number 1247. Here the last digit is 7. But for any number to be divisible by 5, the last digit must be 0 or 5. Here the last digit is 7. So this number is not divisible by 5. So in this way, without doing the actual division, you can find out whether the number is divisible by 5 or not. Next is divisibility by 6. How can you check whether a number is divisible by 6 or not? So far we have done the divisibility rule for 2 as well as for 3 also. So to check whether a number is divisible by 6 or not, we will check the divisibility rule for 2 as well as for 3. If the number is divisible by 2 and 3 both, then the number will always be divisible by 6. So for a number to be divisible by 6, what you will check? First you will check the last digit. The number should end with the even digit or zero. If the number is having the last digit as even number or zero, it means that that number is divisible by 2. Now, if that rule is satisfied, then add all the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then that number will be divisible by 3 also. So the number is divisible by 2 as well as by 3. So if any number satisfies both of these two conditions, then that number will always be divisible by 6. For example, you are given the number 204. Here the last digit of this number is 4, which is an even number. So this number is divisible by 2. Now add all the digits 2 plus 0 plus 4, which is 6. And 6 is divisible by 3. So this number is divisible by So this number is divisible by 2 as well as by 3. So from here we can say that 204 is divisible by 6 also. One another example, suppose you are given 171. Here if I add all the digits 1 plus 7 plus 1, that is 9. 9 is divisible by 9. So the divisibility rule for 3 is satisfied. Now if we check the divisibility rule for 2, here the last digit is 1, which is an odd number. So this number is not divisible by 2. Here the divisibility rule for 3 is satisfied, but 2 is not satisfied. So this number is divisible by 3, but not by 2. So this number 171 will not be divisible by 6. So For any number to be divisible by 6, it must be divisible by 2 as well as it must be divisible by 3 also. Only then the number will be divisible by 6, otherwise not. Next is divisibility rule for 8. How can you check whether the number is divisible by 8 or not? The rule is, if the last 3 digit of the number is divisible by 8, then the number will be divisible by 8. Second, if the last 3 digit of the number are 0, then the number is also divisible by 8. For example, if you are given the number 1256, so we will only divide the last 3 digits by 8. 256. 256 is divisible by 8. So the given number will be divisible by 8. Now suppose you are given a very large number, 1, 2, 4, 3, 6, 1, 7, 6. No need to do the complete division. Just divide only the last 3 digits by the number 8. Here the last 3 digits are 176. 176 is divisible by 8. So the complete number 1, 2, 4, 3, 6, 1, 7, 6 is also divisible by 8. And also if you are given 3, 2, 4, 7, 000, the last 3 digits are 0. So if the last 3 digits of any number are 0, then that number is always divisible by 8. Hence, the given number is divisible by 8. Now, next is the divisibility rule for 9. After 8, the next divisibility rule for 9. How can you check whether the given number is divisible by 9 or not? Just like 3, in the divisibility of rule of 3, what we do? We add all the digits. If the sum is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Same also, if the sum of the digit of a number is divisible by 9, then that number is always divisible by 9. So what you do, whatever number is given, add all the digits. If the sum is divisible by 9, then that number will always be divisible by 9. For example, if you are given 5, 4, 1, 6, 8, 3. So what you do, add all the digits. 5 plus 4 plus 1 plus 6 plus 8 plus 3. The total sum will be 27. 27 is divisible by 9. So the given number 5, 4, 1, 6, 8, 3, that will be divisible by 9. So in this way, you can check whether the given number is divisible by 9 or not without doing the actual division. Next is the divisibility rule for 10. If any number which ends with 0, that number is always divisible by 10. For example, if you are given 110, the last digit is 0. So this number is divisible by 10. Next 1200, last digit is 0. So this number is divisible by 10. 1405, here the last digit is 5. 5 is not divisible. The last digit is not 0. For any number to be divisible by 10, the last digit must be 0. But here the last digit is 5. So this number is not divisible by 10. Now next is the divisibility rule for 11. How can you check whether the number is divisible by 11 or not? If the sum of the digits at odd and even places are equal or differ by a number divisible by 11, then the number is also divisible by 11. Now, what does it mean? Suppose you are given a number 4, 6, 5, 1, 6, 8. Here, first of all, add all the even places 6, 1, and 8. These are the digits at the even places 2, 4, and 6. Second place, fourth place, and 8, sixth place. The digits are 6, 1 and 8. Add all these three digits, 6 plus 1 plus 8. The total sum is 15. Now add all the digits which are at the odd places. 1, 3 and 5. These are the odd places. And the digits at odd places are 4, 5 and 6. 4 plus 5 plus 6, that is also 15. So the rule says that if the sum of the even digits of the even places and odd places are equal, both are equal, or you can find the difference. If the difference is 0, then or it is a multiple of 11, then always the number will be divisible by 11. So if difference is here, difference is 0, so the given number 465168 is divisible by 11. Now another example, 30712. Here the sum of the odd places 3 plus 7 plus 2, which is equal to 12. Now sum of even places, that is equal to 0 plus 1. Sum of even places is equal to 1. Now the sum of odd places is 12 and sum of even places is 1. So difference will be 12 minus 1. 12 minus 1 is 11. So 11 is divisible by 11. So the given number 30712 will be divisible by 11. So this is the divisibility rule for 11, that add the digits at the odd places, add the digits at the even places and then find the difference. If the difference is 0 or it is a multiple of 11, or you can say if the sum of the digits at the even places and odd places are equal or their difference is a multiple of 11, then that number is always divisible by 11. Next is the divisibility rule for 12. The factors of 12, that can be written as 4 times 3. 12 can be written as 4 times 3. So if a number is divisible by 4 as well as by 3, means the number must be divisible both by 4 and 3, then that number will always be divisible by 12. So what was the divisibility rule for 4? That the last two digits must be 0 or they must be divisible by 4. And for the 3, you have to add all the digits and their sum must be divisible by 3. So if both these two conditions are satisfied, then the number is divisible by 12. For example, if you are given the number 253692, here the last two digits, 92 is divisible by 4, first condition is satisfied. So the number, this number is divisible by 4. Now we will check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So add all the digits, the sum is 27. So 27 is divisible by 3. So this number is also divisible by 3. Now the given number 253692 is divisible by 4 as well as by 3. So the given number is divisible by 12. Now next is divisibility rule by 14. 14 can be written as 2 times 7. So if a number is divisible by 2 as well as by 7, then that number will always be divisible by 14. So check the divisibility rule for 2 and for 7. If both these conditions are satisfied, then the number will be divisible by 14. Similarly for 15, 15 can be written as 3 times 5. Check the divisibility rule for 3 and for 5. If the number is divisible by 3 as well as by 5, then definitely it will always be divisible by 15. Next, what is the divisibility rule for 16? If the last 4 digits are divisible by 16, in the divisibility rule of 4, the last 2 digits must be 0 or divisible by 4. In the divisibility rule of 8, last 3 digits must be divisible by 4 So they must be zero. Then the number is divisible by 8. Now divisibility rule of 16 is, now add one more digit. Now the last four digits, they must be divisible by 16 or they must be zero. Then that number is always divisible by 16. Next is divisibility by 18. 18 can be written as 2 times 9. So, if a number is divisible by 2 as well as by 9, then that number is always divisible by 18. So, these are all the divisibility rules. There are some special cases. So far we have not discussed the divisibility rule for 7, 13, 17 and 19. They come under the category of special cases. Yes, these are the special cases that we will discuss in our next lecture. So these are the special cases, divisibility rule of 7, 13, 17 and 19. These four divisibility rules we will discuss in our next lecture. So far, all the divisibility rule will be clear to you. Thank you.